challenges the most, he challenges the hardest. And I've always had that, how you say that, fear of that Christ complex where, you know, if you walk in, I've always thought that if I walked in his shoes, literally, that life was going to kill me. I mean, just like it did him. And for that reason, I purposefully stayed away from trying to walk in his shoes. It's kind of why I coined myself, you know, the bad boy of spirituality, because I ain't all that spiritual. I mean, I love you and everything like that, but I do things, I've done things that were not spiritual at all, you know, and that just, you know, it just showed itself, you know, in all manners and all forms of manifestations. But what I wanted to talk about was just to let you know about parts of the program that I'm going to be going over, and I read the tarot and stuff like that, and I'm heavily into Edgar Cayce, so I'll be referring to the readings a lot, not giving him exact credence for everything, because you're hearing it from me, but it's, you know, I think your life needs to be experienced, so anything that you experience should come through you, you know, because that's what people connect with. So if you're connecting with me, that's pretty much what you'll be connecting with. But I came across a few things, and if I can get this in the next 2 minutes, I wanted to let you know that I'm going to be going over things like ESP, clairvoyance, remote viewing, out-of-body experiences, and what I think about that. I don't have any near-death experiences, although I have committed suicide quite a few times, but I didn't see no white light or anything like that, obviously. And but also mediumship, and what I think about channeling, and also be going into some holistic information. I have a friend of mine, a dear friend of mine, who I'm going to be getting on the show, who's very, very sensitive, very, very intuitive, and totally connected to Source. And I'd like to get her on here and interview her and a few other people who are just fantastic, fantastic resources for being grounded and protecting yourself. And I believe it, as a spiritual warrior, you really do need to protect yourself. So that was one of the reasons why I watched The Right, because it was right up my alley. If I figured out one thing, it was I needed to exercise my own inner demons. And I'll be going into a break, and then we'll be coming back with a few other with the rest of the show.
You're listening to my dad, Dan Lopez, on Spiritual Warriors Day Radio.
And welcome back. And today, let me just continue with what I was talking about as far as exercising your inner demons and angels and demons and the like. I wrote a post a long time ago because my brother had just saw this movie called The Legion or Legion. It was pretty cool. I saw it and I thought it was all right. It was very much tied into a lot of, misconceptions, I'll say, or some person's interpretation of everything, regarding how the angels of, fell and how they were, tied into man, and it just kind of went somewhere and left a whole chunk of stuff out, and it just didn't make absolutely no sense, but it was entertaining. So the name of the article was Five Things to Know About Angels and Legion, and so my brother, who was just starting to get into I don't know about religion, but more, he's very religious now, getting into spirituality and the belief of God and angels and all kinds of stuff like that, you know. So he was asking me all a bunch of questions about the movie and its portrayal of everything. And so I wrote a dissertation in response to all of his questions that he gave me. But, I mean, so here it is. And many who have come close to knowing me know how I have an affinity to the spiritual. I have to admit, when I first saw the trailers to the movie Legion, I was a bit taken back. I was dying to look back at my old studies of angels and all that I remembered. And then my brother emailed me concerning the trailer and the film's implications. And this is how it went. And the first question was, so who is Michael? Well, Michael is an archangel, higher in rank than other angels, known as the Lord of the Way. Michael was charged to be the sole archangel given rank high enough to do battle with legions and of Lucifer himself, who lost his name and was given Satan as a remembrance of the fall. And only the Christ and the Creator of all may ultimately defeat Satan's rulers, powers, and principalities. And I'm going to interject here, because it is through our channeling, you know, the Master, Jesus, God, whatever, Christ, the Christ said, you know, that it is the works of the Father through me that I do these things. And so while we're going to go toe-to-toe with the powers and principalities and all that stuff of the negative forces, you know, whether it's internal stuff that we're dealing with or even the external stuff, which comes in very, very rare times. It is, you know, we call the power that's greater than ourselves to do the battle through us, you know, and for us with the assistance of the angels as we go through them. And it's not that our carnal selves can do the battle alone. This has proven to have an opening of the rebelliousness to say that we're better or greater than. And so that's why a lot of people who would attempt to do such battle wind up falling prey to all kinds of misgivings in the process, you know. So, where was I? It's important to note that Satan, although removed from rank, did not lose any of his stature and power or knowledge or beauty for that matter. It is written that he was as high ranked, being the holder of light, as the seraphim, who are above the cherubim, who are above the archangels. See, you can also look this up and see all the angels in the Bible by Herbert Lockyer, and you can also find such stuff in the Edgar Cayce readings. Another one of his questions was, isn't Legion another name for Satan? And my answer was, actually, that's just from the movie. The actual account was taken from Scripture. When a demon-possessed individual was asked of the entity to reveal itself, and Legion, it means many, which is its true meaning. And I also found that in the rite, you know, while I was witnessing, you know, a reenactment of an exorcism, one of the things that the teacher, the main exorcist, was Anthony Hopkins, had claimed was that you have to call or get the name of the particular demon, and you can then have power over them. I don't know how true that is. I don't know if that's creative license on the part of the writers, or if that's such a case. I mean, I'd have to look that up. And it doesn't say anything in the rites as far as the rites of exorcism that I found that claim such. And Mark 5:9, then he asked him, "What is your name?" And he answered, saying, "My name is Legion, for we are many." Now, obviously, many had decided to attach themselves to that person. When the fall occurred, many fell. Also, you know, or legions fell, for the sons of God looked upon the daughters of man and saw that they were fair and took them wives. And you can read in the ancient texts from the Apocrypha, which are part of the canon, part of the stuff that was excluded from the original Bible. This was also part of the fall, but it's most noted of the written texts. The actual fall, according to Edgar Cayce readings, Lucifer was pissed, and he was jealous that man was higher than the angels, and that he and the angels were to serve man. See, according to the Edgar Cayce readings, there's the statement of the angels are that they have no free will. Okay, their will is directly in line with God's, and they don't have the same right that we do, and they were given the manner to serve us, not as subservience, but as assistants. And one of the reasons for that was because they were already given full access to the powers of God, and man was created in the image of God, given the potential to become gods ourselves as part of a